Small cell lung cancer is the least common form of lung cancer that we treat. It makes up approximately 15% of lung cancer. Patients who present with small cell lung cancer tend to have large primary tumors and large lymph nodes within their chest. As a consequence of those large volume tumors and lymph nodes, they suffer with cough and breathlessness and often chest pain. The survival from small cell lung cancer is unfortunately much worse than non-small cell lung cancer. Even with standard of care treatment, they only survive 10 months. As a consequence, there's very few patients who live to 5 years. The challenge that I face when I treat patients with small cell lung cancer is that the cancer itself grows quickly. The majority of patients, though, I treat with small cell lung cancer have advanced incurable disease. As a consequence of that, I typically use combination chemotherapy. When I first meet patients with extensive stage small cell lung cancer, I explain to them that their disease is likely to respond well to chemotherapy. In fact, many of those patients are impressed when they see the response they've had to their platinum doublet chemotherapy. Unfortunately, though, many of them are devastated when they come back only after a short period of time later to find that their disease has regrown and, on receiving further treatment, does not respond as well as it did. For over 20 years, combination chemotherapy has been the standard of care. Despite over 40 clinical trials, there hasn't yet been any significant change to that standard of care. When you combine chemotherapy with immunotherapy, you're combining a treatment which can gain control of the disease quickly. The immunotherapy is then allowed time to mount an immune response which offers the patient durability. It's now recognized that tumors with high mutational burden are the ones that respond best to immunotherapy drug treatment. Small cell lung cancer is just one of those tumors. As a consequence of that, when patients with small cell lung cancer receive immunotherapy, the immunotherapy encourages their immune system to attack their tumor cells. Over the past 10 years, there's been dramatic developments in the management of patients with lung cancer. Through advances in our understanding of lung cancer, we've seen new drugs such as immunotherapy, new types of chemotherapy, new targeted therapy, but also advances in radiation delivery and even surgery. Patients with extensive stage small cell have disease which grows quickly. You therefore need treatment which can gain control of the disease quickly. As with most new treatments that we see in oncology, we examine their benefits in the advanced setting. I'm hopeful that in future, those benefits will be examined in the limited stage setting of small cell lung cancer. Now, patients who I treat with lung cancer have a wealth of new treatment options, and it's important that we personalize those treatment options to their disease.